So let's begin with the first paper, which is presented by Adolfo Ruiz Calleja. It is called Exploring the Web Data to Bridge Formal and Informal Learning Experiences.
Thank you,
Introduce me. I'm Adolfo Ruiz Calleja from the Physique Group of the University of Valladolid, and I'm going to present an ongoing work that we just started a few months ago. And it is entitled Exploring the Web of Data to Bridge Formal and Informal Learning Experiences. And then, as Rafael says, this is basically using this technology in order to support the learning process, to support the learners. And we will see how this bridging of formal and informal learning, which in my our opinion is something, is a key concept of smart learning education or smart learning environments we are going through. So let's put ourselves in the skin of a learner. Okay, we consider different types of learners or different. Education levels or subjects. I could put ourselves in a learner who is learning in a secondary school in the beautiful city of Palencia, which is very close to here, and is learning about the medieval art, okay, and he's passing by this street. And then his mobile phone starts there is a sound or something, and it says, "Hey, you're close to Ermita de San Juan Bautista. We invite you to visit." Okay, that can be interesting. Okay, so give me more information. And then he gets a description of the temple and how to visit them. So then the learner says, "Okay, let's go, it's only 2 minutes away." He arrives in the temple. And then the application starts asking him questions. As he's a learner of medieval art, he's now taking medieval art in his high school, then he should be able to answer these questions. So it's, what is the architectural style of Ermita de San Juan Bautista? What do you think? The temple that is in front of me now, I think it is small, but it must be Romanesque temple. So he writes, Romanesque. Right, well, the windows and the small thing and white walls and these kind of things. They take a photo of the archivolt of Ermita of San Juan Bautista. Can you identify the particular level from their archivolt? So then he looks at the archivolt. So there is this kind of chess style arcs. Yeah. He looks at them, takes a photo, have a look at it. And when he takes a photo, he gets another question. Compare the windows of Ermita de San Juan Bautista with this Gothic style window. Which difference can you see? Because he looks at this window here, he looks at the ones in the temple that is in front of him, he sees that, oh, there is a lot of decoration, the other one is very narrow, very small, and he can detect in the place the differences between the Gothic style window and the Romanesque style window. Finally, he gets another recommendation, that is to go to this other beautiful church that is not so far. But he says, "Okay, that's enough for learning today. So please notify me when I'm close to it. Don't bother me now." And he continues his work. So we have seen that this application that we intend to build, and we are right now in the process of building it, somehow bridges the formal learning of the student in the high school to the opportunities of informal learning that he finds in his daily life. Now the questions are how. So how should suggest this learning task for the students? How can we do it? How do we know where it is? And how do we know, how the application knows that there is a temple next to it? how to relate a task to the formal education of the student. How do we know that he's learning right now the Romanesque architecture? And how can we obtain the tasks without the need of the teachers to define them? Because there are so very many opportunities of informal learning in our daily life that it would be impossible for the teacher to write down all possible things that the learning is doing. So, these questions drive us to some requirements for our application, which is a system that recommends learning resources based on the student profile and his context. In this case, in this particular case, the context is defined by his physical location. We can consider other scenarios with other type of context. So then we need to define the learning model and the context. And then the learning model should be linked to his formal education. And then we need a huge amount of contextualized resources. And here is where the key concept or the key or our key idea appeared. And it's to exploit the open data available on the web in order to automatically create these resources, these contextualized resources. I asked the question before, and many people said that they know what the open data is. Is anybody who doesn't know it? Great. So, as there are descriptions of very many things that are available in the, well, in this case, churches or buildings, no? And these are geolocalized, and these descriptions are openly available on the web, we can simply take these descriptions, integrate them, create our own data set, and out of this data set, then we create the learning task that will be proposed to the students. This is our, more or less, our. So then the system, our system, has these two parts. The first part would be a context-aware recommended system. And here, this is the typical elements that we can find in a context-aware recommended system. The mobile application that is used by the student recommends learning resources according to the student profile and this context. But also, the student profile is related to an application that is used by the educator in order to configure what are the learning interests of the students. So that the student educator can say, these students are interested in Romanesque art, in this case. On the other hand, we have a system, scripts or processes used by a web of data expert in order to create the learning resources and the context. So then there's a crawler across the web, collects a lot of open data from the web, it creates an internal data set, and then out of a set of templates, then we create with this data set very many learning resources and the related products. So right now we are in the process of developing some already in this part for this specific case, and we have as a first project. So we are using three data sources, the Spanish Wikipedia, Wikidata, and the open data portal of Castilla y León. And out of this, we've got almost 2,000 descriptions of geolocalized entities of Castilla y León, which are like a little bit more than 1,000 religious buildings, 600 civil buildings, castles, walls, palaces, things like that, and another 700 sites of food of interest. 724 of them came from Wikipedia and Wikidata, so the descriptions come from both data sources. There are another, by chance, same amount, 724 that only come from the open data of Junta de Castilla y León. And then there are all 600 of them that we integrated from the three data sources. And this integration has been done by us, taking into account the geolocalization of entities. Problems. Well, no, life is full of problems. And happy, then we have research opportunities. So using third-party data has its drawbacks, because that is not all the data that we would like. We would like to get richer descriptions sometimes, you know? Like, for example, what is the key statue that is inside this temple? Why this temple is so special? And this sometimes it is not the... So, for example, we see that in the Cathedral of León, there is a description that says that they have windows. But they don't say that these windows are especially important. So then we cannot ask especially about the windows. Then another question that is driving the web of data expert crazy is that the services may not be fully available sometimes. And then the data integration issues. Well, data integration is always an issue whenever we are mixing different data sets. Problems that we foresee for our future work once we have this first prototype ready. Then, who creates the question templates? Because right now, the questions are created by the work of data expert. But it would be very, very, very interesting if we allow the teachers to create the templates. So then the teacher says, creates a template, presses the button, and gets a few hundred new questions that can be posed to the students. And then how to extract information from the learning design, because then now we have a configuration configuration application for the teacher in order to say what is the student doing, what is the interest of the student. But the interesting thing would be like what you said, just applying this artificial intelligence, well, maybe not so intelligent, but maybe just collecting from the learning design in a smart learning environment. What are the topics related to the student or related to this course? And out of these topics, extract what are the interests of the learner. So that's